I love that song. My mom used to play that all the time. She'd be cooking in the kitchen, just like
that song would be on in the background.
A scrub is a guy that thinks he's flying, is also known as a buster. Always talking about what he wants and just sits on his broke ass soul. No, I don't want your number. No, I don't want to give you.
I remember I used to listen to this song for nap time. I stayed with my dad at home all day, and he would just always play this song. And then when I like got older, he would be like, remember that song I used to play? No, it wasn't. He was like, remember that song you used to play? Like, don't marry a scrub.
Played, like Celine Dion during nap time, not TLC. Like,
who was listening to Celine Dion during nap time?
My favorite member of TLC? Who exactly? Like 10 to 11 Care?
It's a banger. That's my thoughts.
It really is.
It's a banger then, it's a banger now.
I used to bump that song like back in like middle school. Because I was a fat magnet.
I would get so tired of jamming, I would go to sleep. All right, sorry that I had dance
like,
moves and I wanted to take a nap after.
It's really good. I don't remember most of their other songs, but that was like the most popular song. And it's funny actually because in like a Snapchat video a couple of weeks ago, I heard someone playing that song in her car and it brought back so many memories and now it's just bringing the memories back again and it's a great song.
A fat magnet is basically like, I don't know, like you just attract fat people to you, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, and it wanted my numbers, so you know, this song came up. This song was pretty popular back in the day, so you know, I used to play this song all the time.
When I was in like, I think, I don't know, sometime in middle school, I don't remember what grade, but I remember me and my friends literally used to be obsessed with TLC for no reason, like the whole year, and we would just call ourselves TLC.
I'm gonna sound like such a hypocrite, but I actually don't know the individual members of the band.
I know there are three of them.
Oh well, yeah, I know that. Obviously.
Well, yeah.
Britney Spears, the bald-headed girl.
I had the DVDs, I had the CDs, I had the t-shirts. I went to like every single concert. My dad used to encourage me too, because he loved it, because she's Britney Spears, she's hot as hell.
My favorite thing about her is probably her comeback. You know, how like she had that like crazy meltdown back in 2007, now she came back from that. Honestly, I honestly think it's actually kind of inspirational.
How come her hair grew back so fast though? Like, I mean, didn't she shave like her whole head for like a short? I'm pretty sure it does not take like 24 to 48 hours for your hair to grow back in that period of time.
I do consider her pop royalty. I love Britney Spears and I used to have a poster of her in my locker and in my room. And I think like back then there were tape cassettes.
Hit Me Baby One More Time. She did another song, right?
When I hear this song, I think of Freaky Friday because there was a scene in there where the guy was like singing to Lindsay Lohan outside, and then he's like, "Hit me, baby!" She goes running.
Now I know what movie you're talking about. Okay. I thought you were talking about Friday After Next.
I got them mixed up. They're both Friday.
When you ready? No, wait, is that girl that when you ready, come and get it? That's who? Oh. All right, that is the wrong song.
Take the bass line out. Chicka.
Bam.
Yeah. Let it bump though.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us. Steady treat it. We get kicked. Steady kisses. We get kicked. It's a hard knock life.
From standing on the corners bopping to driving some of the hottest cars New Yorkers ever seen. For dropping some of the hottest verses rappers ever heard. From the dope spot with the smoke block, clinging the murder scene. You know me well from nightmares of a lonely cell. My only hell, but since when y'all niggas know me to fail? Fuck nah.
I just find it a little weird that he like sampled slash, you know, did a cover of a song from Annie. just, I don't know, I think it's a little kind of, a little strange, a little bizarre of a choice, but I mean, like, I don't see Beyonce covering Fiddler on the Roof anytime soon.
I remember it.
Nah, honestly, I actually remember the Anyone, Hard Not Life for Annie, The Sun Will Come Out Tomorrow. No, that's the Hard Like Knife one with the over the kids.
I just remember Mad Kids.
Mad Kids, that's
mad,
the only one.
Mad Little Men's, you know, Little Women's.
I think it's really original. It's taken from a Broadway show and made into a rap version.
I didn't really grow up listening to Jay-Z, so honestly, I'm only really familiar with the song because I saw it, because it was in the third Austin Powers movie.
I really remember it from Goldmember, the third Austin Powers movie.
Jay-Z's the man, though. He's a top five artist. Businessman, he's a man. Hard Not Life, I was, you know, as a kid, you know, the song was for us.
Jay-Z is an amazing rapper. I think that, you know, he's been great from the start and he's still good today. Like, some rappers kind of, you know, deplenish, like, over time, but I think that he stayed good the whole time.
I don't think Jay-Z has a hard knock life right now. I mean, like, he has like millions and millions of dollars and he's married to Beyonce.
I'm not sure what his life was like in the past, you know, maybe a little bit. I mean, a lot of black people go through hardships.
What the hell did you just say?
But I mean, sort of white people, everyone does. Like, you know, he might have been on the streets, like a little bit in the hood. I mean, you know, you really don't know. But now I think that his life is great. Like, he does his music, he's a really good rapper, he has a lot of fans, and he's married to Beyonce.
Honestly, being married to Beyonce alone, like, you know, how can you really complain about anything?
It's the Hard Knock Life!
Are y'all ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Oh!
Who lives in Empire under the sea?
Love like a fish.
SpongeBob SquarePants.
That was beautiful, bro.
I didn't know it was on its 9th season. That's a long
time.
Wow.
You know, between SpongeBob, Pokemon, and The Simpsons, what is it with animated shows that star yellow protagonists that don't know when to stop?
That's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
But SpongeBob is low-key a pervert, like the whole show concept. So, I mean, we recognize it now, but the little kids watching it don't, so.
I knew it was still rolling, like still going on, but I didn't know there was 9 seasons.
My favorite character of SpongeBob would have to be Mr. Krabs, solely because he was a money-grubbing lowlife.
My favorite character was definitely Mrs. Puff. Mrs. Puff was a freaking badass. I mean, she must have gotten arrested like 30 times in the show. And she has put up with so much, like, in the show too.
You know, I used to love Patrick. But my favorite character is probably the guy that's always there in some kind of chaos and says, my leg!
My leg! My leg!
Thank you!
My leg!
My leg! My leg!
Oh, my leg!
My leg!
Yeah, I know.
I got mad funny.
Yeah, he's cool.
I love Sandy Cheeks, especially like her and SpongeBob when they would do the karate stuff.
Is that enough?
Maybe just one more. Or two.
And it wouldn't be Sandy, it would be like a random person.
Hi-ya!
My leg!
Thought you could sneak up on me at work, did ya?
Sandy's hot. She's a nice piece of brown skin. I like Sandy. Yeah, I don't really like squirrels, but Sandy's all right. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I get that. You know what I'm saying?
My favorite episode was definitely Band Geeks. Band Geeks was like the best episode.
Everybody ready? And the one, and the two, and the one, two, three, four. Okay, new theory.
But can I ask you something, Kevin? What? Is mayonnaise an instrument?
No, Patrick, mayonnaise is not an instrument.
My favorite episode is, you ever seen the episode where SpongeBob had to write an essay and then he'll pass the class?
Now let's see how it looks so far. The threat time!
There's an episode with this pickle guy. He comes in and he's like, you don't make good Krabby Patties, SpongeBob. And SpongeBob's like, here, taste this Krabby Patty. And the guy was like, there was no pickles on my Krabby Patty. So the entire 30 minutes is about SpongeBob trying to put pickles on a Krabby Patty, which is a ridiculous plot for an entire 30-minute episode.
My favorite episode would probably be the one where he goes to, what is it, rock bottom, where he can't figure out how to get back home because it's like straight down.
Yeah, I remember that
episode of
the... Yeah. They always
talk like... understand your accent.
Your accent.
Barnacles!
It's like what Grandpa Squarepants said, never chase after a bunt, especially if it's going up at a 90-degree angle.
That was a pretty scary.
My favorite episode would have to be Jellyfish Jam when SpongeBob takes in a jellyfish as a pet and they have a dance party. That song still is stuck in my head.
I think a Krabby Patty tastes like a burger. That's like a burger with just a lot of sodium and a lot of like salt.
Oh my gosh, it has to be like the best thing on earth. It has to be better than like a frat from Starbucks. Like it has to be really, really good if everybody wants it.
Yo, I think it tastes like Five Guys burger times 10.
I read a theory about Krabby Patties and it said that like since you don't know who Pearl's mother is, they're assuming that when the whale died her mother that Mr. Krabs turn that into the Krabby Patties and is going to use Pearl for that too later on. So maybe it tastes like whale. I don't know. I know, right? Wasn't my theory, but.
It probably tastes like heaven. The way they describe it and the way that Plankton's always trying to steal it. It's probably tastes like heaven, yeah.
You don't like that show?
No.
We interrupt this program to bring you Courage the Cowardly Dog Show, starring Courage the Cowardly Dog! Abandoned as a pup, he was found by Muriel, who lives in the middle of nowhere with her husband, Eustace Bay! Yeah. But creepy stuff happens in nowhere. It's up to Courage to save his new home!
Stupid dog! You made me look bad!
Not at all. I thought it was the funniest thing on the planet when I was a child.
Yes. I was petrified of Courage the Cowardly Dog. Like, I couldn't watch it after, like, a certain time. Like, once it got dark outside, I wouldn't watch it.
Honestly, it really did to the point where, like, I had to sleep with all the lights on in my room because, like, I don't know, it's just some creepy stuff that happens in Courage the Cowardly Dog, and you know, it's just like nightmares at that time when I was younger.
This show, like, freaked me out, like, ballistically. Maybe not ballistically, but it was freaky as heck.
It didn't scare me, I just thought it was, like, really abnormal, like, the things that were drawn or, like, didn't they have an episode where something just, like, made noise the whole time and that was it? Like, it was just odd, but I liked it. I thought it was, not cute is the word I wouldn't say, but it was different.
The only thing I know about Courage is that he was a dog, he was purple, and there was a hole in his teeth. He was pink. He was pink, he was a nasty fuchsia color, and he had a hole in his teeth.
Is he tall?
Jim, 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 Jim. He speaks like in gibberish, I believe. No, he does. He talks like an educated man that went to like college.
I remember one of them. It was like a tall ghost, kind of like Grim the Reaper body shape, and he had like a green face, and he would like talk so weirdly. Return to
slime. What's your offer?
That one was the scariest. I was petrified of him.
That big, nasty foot. It was like green and purple. It swallowed Eustace, Muriel, Courage, and Courage had to eat the nest.
It would probably have to be a tie between Ramses and that big white head with the realistic looking face. I don't remember what it was called, but it was like a big white head that like had like a real looking face.
I feel like somewhere in the Midwest, but I didn't think maybe Kansas, because everything bad happens in Kansas. That's where Dorothy like got her to.
Nowhere? That's Area 51. Nowhere is Area 51. That's why all this keeps happening to them.
I think that the monsters, I think they might have just been, you know, just everything that's normal, but just, you know, through a dog's perspective. Because dogs are paranoid of everything.
If it was happening to Muriel and Eustace, then it's definitely real. Because Courage had to be the one to save him. And think about it, when he doesn't wake up from a dream, so this is like the real thing in this cartoon, so.
I remember catching an episode here and there when I was a kid. When I look back at it now, I can't remember much from it.
Oh, yes.
I watched that show a lot.
Yes.
Yeah, I watched that show. Like
that was probably one of the best shows on Nickelodeon.
My favorite episode was when Tito, when he built his confidence and he finished last in that race. Excellent.
There was one where Sam was got like really good at hockey. I don't know why. There was an episode where he was really good at sports for like a day. It didn't happen again. But he was really good for like a day. And I was like, you know what? There's hope for me too. If Sam can be good, I can be all right.
Look at that too. Whoa. The squid got barrel. Go, Sammy.
Are you good?
No.
All right.
No. I was the same.
It was one where Reggie had a little crush, so she decided to like, because he was like a really, really good at everything too, so she decided that like she acted like she couldn't do anything, and then like later on like she found out that he was a jerk and she was like, oh, I can do this better than you anyway, and she showed him up.
There was an episode where they thought that I think
if you say the same one that I'm thinking of, go.
It was I don't remember if it was Tito or yes, it was Tito.
They thought he was a killer.
They thought that
Oh my gosh, this can't be happening.
Bloody like, murdered Raymond.
Oh my god, and like, whatchamacallit, I liked also the one with the hurricane when Twister lost his camera and he went back out into the hurricane just to get his camera, which was waterproof anyway.
My favorite character is Tito. You know, the big fat dude.
Yeah, I heard you like him big, right? Go ahead.
Tito was my favorite character because, like, he just comes up with these weird shits. He says funny shit. He says funny stuff, actually. Funny stuff in general because, like, it makes me laugh. He's cool. He's a cool person.
Nah, he's a man.
Tito. He wasn't really in the game. Well, I love Tito. He always gave them free smoothies. Like, if I was on a beach, I would want those free smoothies.
Otto. That was my guy. That was the main character, I believe. I haven't seen him in a minute, but he was like the athletic one, the cool one. He was always getting in trouble, but he always figured it out. Otto's a man.
Rocket Girl. Reggie. I don't know, when I was little, I just wanted to be her because she was like so athletic and she did everything that the boys could do.
For Christmas, like for 3 years in a row, I asked my parents for a surfboard. And they really, well, I didn't even know how to swim, so I don't know why I was asking for support. But I remember one year they got me a surfboard, and like they were trying to be funny, like they're just, well, like I don't really like them like that, because they got me the surfboard, then they got this little kiddie pool for the backyard. Like, how am I about to, the surfboard didn't even fit in the pool, so I never use it. It's still in my basement to this day.
I got a skateboard later, like in life, when skateboard and, you know, DC was popping, like middle school. But I think Rocket Power started that.
Yeah, like I really wanted to learn how to surf, but there is no place, because I'm from Long Island, there was like, I mean, I guess there's places, but back then my mom was like, you're not surfing, what are you talking about? So she bought me a skateboard, and I tried skateboarding, and I busted my butt, so I stopped.
The funniest or most memorable scene.
What's American Pie about?
You've never seen American Pie. College students, a lot of sexual activity.
It was when he wanted to, like, basically fab his Johnson, you know, if you will. And he thought that the tube next to his bed was, like, lubricant, and it was crazy glue instead. So, like, he, like, handful just went for it, and it just got stuck to himself, basically. And then he tried to, like, open the door with his mouth, fail. Jumped out the window, and then basically got called by the police, like, you know, for they accused him for breaking into the house he was originally in, and like his hand was just still there, like, so he was just on top of the house just like this, you know, trying to run around and whatnot.
Get your hand up, goddammit!
I can't, I'm glued.
I, for some reason, I just, like, this is all I remember, the like pie masturbation scene.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Huh? Jim?
It's not what it looks like.
The pie. Dude screwing the pie. It was weird. It was funny. Pie never saw it coming. I like that scene.
Oh, okay. That's disgusting. No, that's gross. That was the gross scene.
I always thought that was Degrassi.
Drinking, a lot of stupid. Degrassi?
My favorite scene from Big Daddy, definitely when he peed on the, when he peed on the wall, I think it was. I can't actually remember the movie completely, but I distinctly remember him peeing on something.
Lil Sonny had to go use the bathroom, and they were on their way to McDonald's, and then he tried to go into the restaurant, and the guy was like, that's not my problem. He's like, yo, I got a kid here, you gotta use the bathroom, he's gonna be in and out. He's like, that's not my problem. So then he goes around, and then he pees with the dude, with Sonny, on the restaurant.
And we're off. That's not too difficult, right? And we're both losing weight.
My favorite scene from Big Daddy was the scene when Julian and Sonny, they're at the door, and he, like, it's a really sad scene, and Sonny, like, is leaving or something because he can't be adopted. And Julian is, like, just this cute little kid, and he's like, but I want my own ass.
But I want my own ass. I want my own ass.
Sonny made a great dad, I think. Well, at first he was a trash dad. I mean, we can all identify that he was a bad dad at the beginning. But in the end, I'm like, you're a great dad. I was like, maybe I should try to show my dad this so he can be more Sonny-ish. My dad's a good dad, but he should be a little bit more Sonny.
He's a great dad.
Sonny was a great dad.
He's all the aspects of a dad that a young kid would want to have in their lives, pretty much, right?
Exactly.
Sonny was the best dad ever, and I would want him to be my dad, but I do love my dad still, but he's just a really cool guy. Like, I don't know, he's awesome. He was my favorite.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Shagging. I thought it was like a word of, like, swag. I don't know.
Can you use it in a sentence?
It refers to, like, I think shagging is like the long carpet, right? It's a really long carpet that has, like...
No, baby.
No?
You see, when a man and a woman love each other very much, they come together...
And they shag.
And they shag.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Shaggy sounds a little shaggy. Provocative, if you ask me.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah, baby.
Right.
Do I know what shagging is? I think I have an idea on it. You know.
Isn't shagging, like, stage 3? Like that, you know, like, yeah.
My thoughts on Dr. Evil. Well, he's a very misunderstood guy. He just needs some love, don't we all?
I wish I could have been friends with Dr. Evil, because I don't know, I feel like he has a lot of issues, but he just needs a friend. He just needs someone to hold him.
Can I have a hug?
Dr. Evil was an evil bastard, but I feel like if it wasn't for Dr. Evil, Austin Powers wouldn't have been funny. So,
get out of here. I mean, get out of here. Because even though I don't remember this movie, Mini-Me.
There's no Dr. Evil, there's no Mini-Me.
Throw me a freaking bone here.
Lil 1, this guy 0.
Dr. Evil is a sly, funny individual. Like, I still don't get the whole pinky thing. I don't know what he's doing with it. Like, is he biting the nail? Is he thinking? I don't know, but yeah, I like that guy. I don't know. I don't have a problem with him.
Fast Bastard was really disgusting.
He was nasty.
He used to rub his nipples like this.
Do you find me sexy? Oh, look at my titties. Oh, ah.
Yo, Fat Bastard, man.
That's your man's?
Yo, that's my man's 10 grand, son. He taught me a lot. Fat Bastard was the man.